What's up, Gushy here. Today, we're going to be going over how to play Black Widow in Marvel's Avengers. By this time, the free beta weekend should be finishing up. And by far, Black Widow has been my favorite character to play. Which is crazy because I actually started out with Ms. Marvel and the Hulk. Just because they actually have those intrinsic abilities that give them superpowers. But I found that Widow has the most reliable playstyle to stay alive, and she has the highest mobility, excluding all the characters that can actually fly. So in this video, we're going to be going over Black Widow's heroic abilities, her skill tree, and what I think the best skills she has are, and the typical playstyle that I use while playing Black Widow, and which I think is pretty reliable. So starting off with her heroic abilities, her ultimate is called Power Surge. And I honestly think this is one of the strongest ultimates in the game. It basically gives a damage buff to all of her abilities and a movement increase to just move around the map super quick. And the reason why I think that this is one of the best ultimates in the game is that her heavy attack breaks shields and stuns enemies, all with an AoE that you can spam super quickly. And this is a great tool to clear out any mid to low tier enemies and do a decent damage to any high tier enemies. Her assault heroic is called Widow's Bite. And this shoots out an electrostatic shock, which immobilizes enemies within a short AoE. And the stun time differs depending on what tiered enemy it is. So in this example, it's good for taking down larger tiered enemies to stop them from attacking. Or if lower tiered enemies are grouped up, it can be used as crowd control to stun multiple enemies at once. Finally, her support heroic is called Veil of Shadows. And this cloaks all nearby teammates and makes enemies in proximity vulnerable to takedowns. And this is super important for the playstyle that I go for, which is really centered around takedowns. Veil of Shadows can be used offensively or defensively, and lasts a decent amount of time. And as I mentioned before, takedowns are essential to this build, mostly because Widow doesn't have an intrinsic ability to passively give health back. So takedowns are a really reliable way to get health back. And there are other reasons why I focus on takedowns. One, they do a massive amount of damage. Two, they give you invulnerability frames all throughout the takedown animation. And three, initiating takedowns, animation cancels any attack you're in, the only exception being when you're in the air. So next, let's go into the skill tree, and the skills that we're going to be looking for are any ones with high stun damage. The higher the stun, the faster enemy's stun meter fills up, decreasing the time to initiate the takedown. And honestly, there's only one attack that you really need. The rest are more for utility. If we go to the heavy attack tree, the first heavy attack combo using the nightstick, each deals a medium stun damage, but increases every time you hit them. And this is your main way you're going to be inflicting stun damage. All low tiered enemies should have their meter filled in one combo string, mid tier enemies should fill up in two, and then tier 3 enemies take a little bit longer, but with the utility that Black Widow has, she can easily deal with them pretty safely. This is where her ranged attacks come pretty handy. In the first column of the ranged attack tree is full auto shot. Using the third ability within that tree gives all her bullets stun rounds, increasing the stun damage dealt by 15%. And this is pretty good if you're using the takedown approach. However, if you like the higher damage options, you can go with that as well. And this is more personal preference. The high caliber rounds are a little bit harder to aim and has a really slow fire rate. And the regular bullets are somewhere right in between. If you want to get up and personal, Widow's dodge evasion ability lets you perform a perfect dodge, which is really easy to proc compared to other heroes. So going up against lower tiered enemies that have shields, there are two ways to get around them. The first is using her power attack impact grenade to break the block, and the second is simply just to vault over their shield using operative's feint. And I think this is the better option because it doesn't have a startup animation and leaves them vulnerable after. However, I found that this move is a little bit finicky sometimes, and I end up just running into the enemy without Widow vaulting over them. So I really hope this gets fixed. Finally, the last part of Widow's kit that you're going to be using a lot is Widow's line in the defense skill tree. This lets you hook enemies and zip to them really quickly. And this is the main reason why I said that Widow has one of the highest mobilities in the game. That's basically everything you need to know about Widow's main playstyle. A thing to note is that the gear will also affect how fast you deal stun damage. Under your hero's rating, the heroic rating in particular, armor's intensity affects how much stun damage you do. So if you have gear that gives a boost to intensity, try to focus on that. Also, there are several gear perks that I found super useful for this build. The most valuable perk that I found is called Critical Spark, and this gives an almost 35% chance that takedowns grant a heroic charge burst for all heroics. And since this build focuses on takedowns, you're going to be getting your heroic abilities every 1 minute or so, depending on how many takedowns you're getting. And this is the only perk that I found so far that reduces the cooldowns of your heroic abilities. In this Widow build, I'm also focusing on cosmic damage. So the perk Cosmic Meridian is pretty useful as it inflicts cosmic damage on heavy combo finishers. Also, the perk Cosmic Parabellum Ammo lets pistol shots deal cosmic damage, or the perk Cosmic ACP, which makes ranged full auto shots deal cosmic damage, are also pretty useful. If you want to learn more about why I chose cosmic damage, I'd recommend checking out my status effects video, where I go over all these status effects and what they do. And that's everything you need to know on the best way that I found to play Black Widow. To all my Widow mains out there, let me know in the comment section below if you play the same way, or if you found a different strategy that works even better. I hope you learned something in this video, and maybe even convinced some of you guys to try Widow out. With that, thanks for watching, hope to catch you in the next one, and peace.